Hello friends, in this video I will be talking about financial and non-financial sources of risk. Now, the topic for this video is financial versus non-financial risk sources. Basically, these are the types of risk an organization or an individual would face. Let's start with financial risks. Short form is LCM. L means liquidity risk, C means credit risk or counterparty risk, M means the market risk. Let's study. Pehla, liquidity risk. It is the risk of receiving less than market value or fair value. Basically, if today if you want to sell your house and you want money tomorrow itself, so basically you need that liquidity. So if it is worth 1 crore, someone will pay you just 90 lakh or 80 lakh. Because of that immediate need of funds. That is known as liquidity risk. Risk of receiving less than market value. Then, credit risk, counterparty risk or default risk. This is basically risk of loss when one party fails to honor the contract. If your borrower has not paid you the amount, basically if lender is a bank and borrower is a customer, agar wo customer ne paisa pay nahi kiya, then that is known as credit risk or counterparty risk or default risk. Last one is the market risk. Market risk is basically that systematic risk which affects everyone. So there is a risk arising from movements in interest rates, stock prices, exchange rates, commodity prices, etc. So these are market variables. If these variables fluctuate, then it is a risk. Next is non-financial risk. The short form is SMART. Hello, SMART T2 hai, matlab T se do answer hoga, and similarly O2, so O se do head point hoga. S stands for solvency risk. Risk that an organization will run out of cash and it won't be able to carry on its business. So basically insolvent ho jayega, running out of cash. M se model risk. Risk of wrong or erroneous valuation of stocks or assets due to valuation models used. Basically, you are using some wrong valuation model to value a stock or an asset, and then it can be an error. Example, using DDM, if you remember dividend discount model, if you remember the formula, D1 upon P0 plus G and something like that. Or D1 upon KE minus G. Now, this was the formula of KE and this is the formula of price, basically value. Now, if you use this formula for a growth stock means that it won't pay dividend, it will reinvest the funds in its own business. If you use DDM for a growth stock that hardly pays dividend, then you are making a mistake. This is known as model risk. Basically, whatever valuation model you've used, like DDM, dividend discount model, it can be wrong for a growth stock. So that is one risk. Next is accounting risk. A for accounting risk. Risk of mistakes in accounting. Now, accounting mein kya mistake ho sakta hai? So journal entry mein mistake ho sakta hai. Numbers feed karne mein mistake ho sakta hai. Or risk of using assumptions, estimates, methods, etc. If you remember, FRA mein sikha tha, DEPRI. DEPRI, original cost minus residual value divided by estimated life. Now here, this residual value is estimated. Your life is estimated. So ye sab assumptions wagaira hota hai. If you make some mistakes in those, then that is accounting risk. R se, regulatory risk, so risk of changes in regulations governing that entity. Now, there are some regulations for banks or for NBFCs or for insurance companies. Now, if these regulations change and if it has some adverse effect, then it is a regulatory risk. T say, tax risk, risk of changes in tax laws. For example, GST rate increase. If your product's GST rate increases, then the consumer will have to pay more for it. So if you remember, restaurants ke case mein hua tha India mein. For restaurants, earlier GST was 18%. but then it was brought down to 5%. So this is a favorable condition for the consumer and it is not a risk at all. But had it been the other way around, first it were 5 and then it became 18%, then it would have been a tax risk. Again, there is one more T, T for tail risk. Risk of extreme events happening. If you remember skewness and kurtosis, see, this is a normal distribution. If you remember skewness, ye negative skew ho gaya. Basically, more events having negative outcomes, or kurtosis, if you remember, fat tails. ये जो है फैट टेल्स. नाउ व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय दीज फैट टेल्स? बेसिकली जो एक्सट्रीम आउटकम्स होते हैं उसमें प्रोबेबिलिटी ज़्यादा हो गया एट दिस एंड और एट दिस एंड. सो एक्सट्रीम इवेंट्स, आई विल गिव यू वन एग्जांपल. इफ यू आर कंपाइलिंग अ स्टॉक्स रिटर्न डेटा, यू हैव समथिंग लाइक दिस. फर्स्ट ईयर में 1% रिटर्न आया, फिर 10, फिर 12, 14 and then 1000. See, in this case, this is 1% and 1000% is an extreme end. So these extreme returns don't occur frequently, but it can occur. So ye sab jo hota hai, this is known as a tail risk. Basically, extreme events happening, extremely positive or extremely negative. Health risk or death risk. So this is risk of deteriorating health of individuals, not for companies but for individuals. L, longevity risk. Just like death risk is the risk of not living, longevity risk is the risk of living longer than you expected. So risk of living more than expected, it is a risk of outliving your assets which you had saved for your retirement. Next L is legal risk, risk related to law. So risk of being sued, someone can sue you because you broke a law or you were not aware of that law and then you get to pay some penalty. O for operational risk, risk arising from people and processes of an entity. Basically, because of your employees, there is some operational hazard happening. That is a risk which is known as operational risk. Other risks like terrorism, natural calamity, earthquake, fire, etc., etc. Let's study the interaction between the risks. See, it is not that ye jo smart hello ya LCM, ye jo bhi risk tumne padha, it is not that only one risk will be happening. These can be interacted in such a way that all the risks can come down together and then it will affect you. So let's see one example. The above mentioned risk can interact in several ways. Usually, market risk leads to credit risk. See, in the market, if interest rates are fluctuating, then it can lead to credit risk. Now, that credit risk means that you won't get your money back, which can further lead to operational risk. Now, your people and your processes of your organizations, even that can cause a risk because paisa hi nahi hai. And then ultimately, settlement risk. There is no settlement happening at the end. So market risk led to credit risk, which led to operational risk, which led to settlement risk. This is how it interacts. It is a chain of risks. Let's see one example. The 2008 crisis. So there was market risk plus there was leverage risk because there was a lot of borrowing. There was liquidity risk, risk of receiving less than the market value. And of course, there was solvency risk, risk of running out of cash. So risks will interact in this way. It is not that every risk is in isolation. It can be in combination. Thank you guys for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ikeda and subscribe to Ikeda.